Hello, I'm Reverend Sam, and I'm your host on The Secret of Glory and Power. When a child is born, in ancient time, before our parents know the Lord, they will take the child to the priest, the Ifa priest. They will say, please, can you please tell us what this child has been ordained by God to become? And in the olden days, whatever they say that child is ordained to become is what the parent of that child will train the child to grow into. And do you remember also that when Jesus was born, on the eighth day they took Jesus into the temple, that means Mary and Joseph, the father and the mother. And, you know, a woman was there and was speaking about the future of Jesus. The woman began to talk about Jesus. Simeon began to talk about Jesus. Now, all those things are supposed to let you know that none of us come to this world for nothing. Nobody produced anything for no reason. I am an advocate of the fact that there's no waste product in this world. I've been sharing this idea for many, many years. You are created into this world for a purpose. But when you enter into this world, enemies see your glory. The devil see your glory. And it raises a lot of opposition. The opposition may come from the enemy of the father's house, the enemy of the mother's house, in your place of work. There is unusual envy about you in your place of work. You know, something used to happen to me, and after a long time, I come to understand it. Whenever I'm praying to get something like property, because it has happened more than twice, I will just discover that as soon as the whatever property or whatever inheritance that I'm supposed to have, as soon before I get it, nobody will look at it. But as soon as I get it, and as soon as I see it, and I begin to bid, and I begin to make negotiation, you start seeing people come. I don't know, maybe it is the same anointing. You know, the people will now be having problem of selecting who to sell it to. That's why what I always do is that I always trust God for favor, that whatever is mine will not go to the hand of another person. That glory, that experience has been working in my life for a long time. For some times I was worried. Why is it that whenever I try to say I want to get this thing, then everybody will start coming to get it? My glory is the type that attracts competition. I just know it. Many years ago, some pastors who used to be my friends, some of them, after a while, they began to speak to some of my leaders in church, especially the youths, and they started trying to sweet talk them to come to their church. And these are pastor friends that I trusted. And I'm like, why must they do that? Those youths, a few of them yielded, others don't. But the point is this. I know that is the kind of glory I carry. So when I see people envious of me, I know I am in the right direction. When I see people trying to do what I do, I know I am doing the right thing. So I will perfect it, I will work on it. What am I trying to say? The Bible says, rule thou in the midst of your enemies. Stop being afraid of your enemies. If truly, you know the God you serve, I'm talking about the Almighty God. If you know Him through the Lord Jesus Christ, then relax. You know, I always tell people something. Any glory that does not attract opposition is not a great glory. Have you ever been to an auction site before where they are trying to buy, maybe they are trying to buy some ancient equipment or cars or something like that? Somebody will say, 3,000. Another person, 3,200. 3,400. The vendor said 3,002. We say 3,800. They are bidding for the same thing. You know why? Because they can see a perceived value on that particular product. That's the way your destiny is. Satan is bidding for your life. God is bidding for your life. Just don't let Satan win. This is where I start today on the story of Gideon, the second part. When you look at the life of Gideon, Gideon did not allow the enemy to win. How do I know that? Because at a particular time in Gideon's life, God told him, Go and destroy the altar of Baal that your father and your genealogy have been worshiping. Go and destroy that altar. I want to become your God. I want to do great things through you. And the truth is, every one of us, if God is going to make you great, our God is a jealous God. You cannot be mixing your faith in a fake prophet. You know, this reminds me of something. I have these ministers of mine many, many years ago. They won visa lottery to come to America. We were very happy for them. I'm talking about like 15 years ago. We were very happy for them. And I'm like, thank God though. And even though the wife, the parents worship in a church where they believe in doing some other things that are not biblically right. I don't want to mention church name. We were praying and trusting God and fasting and trusting God that they will go for the interview and then herself, her husband, because to tell you the truth, they were very committed to me. They were very committed to me in the early days of our ministry. But you know what happened? They didn't give them. But God told me they're going to give them. God told me that there's not going to be any problem because they have already been shortlisted, they have already been invited just for interview to confirm what was on the system. They were not given that visa lottery. The thing was cancelled. And I'm like, why, Lord? For weeks I said, God, no, that's not what you told me. These people are faithful to you. They are serving you. And you know what I found out later? I'm talking about forgetting about the idols of your father's house and serving the living God alone. I later found out that they went to one church. And we are Pentecostal. I believe only whatever the New Testament tells me to do. And God has been giving us great testimonies. But this couple went to a church where they were given some things, you know, some other things to tie together, to use when they are going. And so when they went there, of course, the glory of God on my life cannot follow them with that thing that they carried. Because they were deceiving me that they are going in the name of the God of grace. But they were going with another thing. When I found out, I felt very, very bad. Because this man only had primary 6 education. It was a great opportunity. I want you to know something. You can't deceive God. You cannot deceive God. You either make up your mind you are going to serve God completely, or you go and serve Satan. Putting God with some idolatry identities cannot work. God is a jealous God. God said, my name is jealous. That's why I told the people of Israel, thou shalt not serve any other God before me. And in case you don't know, one of the temptations that Satan gave Jesus was that he was going to give Jesus the whole world and all the glory. All that Jesus needed to do was to bow down and worship Satan. And Jesus said, no, it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord your God, and only him shalt thou serve. Until you can say that to Satan, despite your hardship, you are not ready for greatness. Everyone that has been great in this life is either they are deep in their covenant with God, or they are deep in their covenant with Satan. Of course, those who have covenant with Satan end up regretting it. They may enjoy their life, but their children will suffer because there is always negative consequences that follow any covenant that any man has with the powers of darkness. So my point is this. Do you want your glory to shine? Do you want that glory God has given to you to manifest? Do you want your world to celebrate your gifting? You've got to serve God with the whole of your heart. God told Gideon, you have to go and destroy the altar of Baal that your father's house had been serving. I'm not asking you to go back to Africa and go and destroy the altar that your fathers have been serving. I'm not saying that. The Lord said to me, that's not what I'm telling them. What I'm telling them is that each of you are now the temple of the living God. I am the temple of the living God. Whether you have accepted Jesus or not, every one of us, we are created in the image and the likeness of God. All of us are spirit, but everyone that have not accepted Jesus into their life, you are a dead spirit. But all of us that have given our life to Jesus, we are living spirits. And we are the temple of God. And God is saying that in your heart, you have to break down every altar of Baal. Every belief in fetish things, special perfume, all those idolatrous identities. I don't want to mention name. I am not here to talk about anybody's oppression or whatever. Everyone will give account to God. I am talking to you that if you believe in inanimate object, if you believe in any particular person more than the Almighty God, your glory cannot shine. In fact, the truth is, if your glory shine, they will say they are the one that make your glory to shine. There was this guy in Nigeria, they call it transmission. I don't know, those of us who are a bit older, you remember him. That guy transmission that time, he had so many businesses. We had that it was a particular prophet that helped him to do one particular enchantment that make his fame to shine. His fame shined so much. But one year, when this particular prophet wanted to celebrate a particular celebration and he expected transmission to be there, and the guy was not there, and the man said, "Shebi is the one that make him great, he will bring him down," and he brought him down. That's why the Bible says, "Woe to that, to any man that put their trust in men." If any man of God telling you, "Don't worry, I'll do it for you," idolatry, beware. No man can take the place of God. God said to Gideon, "Destroy the altar." That is in chapter 6. God said to him, "Destroy the idol in your father's house. Destroy it. Stop being afraid of the idols. Focus on God. And focus on your vision." Many of us, we are too focused on the negative that our eyes are blocked to the opportunity that surrounds us. The greatness that will make you great is not seen already. The Bible says, "What eyes have not seen, what ears have not heard, what has not come to the understanding of men is what God has prepared for those who love Him." Ideas that will make you great is not a copycat or imitation of somebody else's idea. It's unique to you. It might look like somebody else's idea, but there is a uniqueness that you are going to add to make it your own. You brand it in your own name. Gideon break the altar. Gideon destroyed the altar. And after he destroyed the altar, you know what God said again? God said, "Gideon, I want you to sacrifice on that same altar, sacrifice to me, the Almighty God." That means it's not just for you to say, "I renounce evil." You must embrace good. If you're a servant of God and you're watching me, the Bible says concerning Jesus in Hebrews chapter 1, He loved righteousness and He hated sin. That's why God anointed him with the oil of gladness. God gave him gladness above his fellows. Why? He made a choice. Even if you are not a pastor, for you to excel and succeed and work strong and become great, you've got to make up your mind, "I am going to hate sin and anything that represents the devil. And I'm going to develop special likeness, special love for righteousness and everything that represents God." Listen. Whatever is going to last does not come to pass in a haste. It takes time for the baby in the womb of a woman to mature before it's born. If you want to harvest any seed, it takes time for the seed to die, it will start sprouting again, and then it becomes a tree, and then it gives out its branch, and the branch gives out the fruit. Everything has process of time. I am not saying that you are going to become millionaire tomorrow. I am not saying that. I used to be like that, you know, many, many years ago when I was still younger. I lost a lot of millions of naira. I lost hundreds of thousands of money in dollars, in hard currency, because I wanted to be rich quick. But I later discovered that half-baked bread does not last. Half-baked miracle does not last. Allow the process of time to work. Give time to everything. That's why don't pursue too many things. Don't pursue too many things. Don't say, "I'm going to pursue this idea, pursue that idea, pursue that idea." You will end up having none. Pursue one idea you are convinced of. Pursue one idea that consumes your heart while you are sleeping, and you will succeed. And let me tell you this, those of you that have businesses and you are watching me, take advantage of the anointing of God on my life. Bring your advert to this show. There is no way, I am speaking with 110% assurance, there is no way you will do business with my anointing and you will not have progress. Kosheche. If you can see with the help of the Spirit, you will know I am a very good connection for you. I am not just a servant of God. I have an anointing of God to prosper people. So call the number on the screen for advert rates. And then make sure that your advert is on this TV program. Listen, this is the program to put your advert. Call your husband, tell your friend. If you want to do, maybe you have wedding anniversary, you want to do wedding anniversary, you want to have wedding, burial, bring the advert on this show. As you do, you will be helping this show to stay on air. You will also be helping us to think of enlargement so that more people can get blessed and more time can be allotted to this program. So I expect to hear from you. Now, so you have to build the altar of God in your heart. You have to serve God and serve Him alone. And like I've said to you, everything has a process. If you want to bake cake, it's going to take time. You have to mix the flour. You must be careful in the measurement and all the chemicals, and then you give the flour time to, you know, to, I don't know how you call it. It becomes soft, and then you put it in the oven at a particular degree, and then you give some time, and after that you bring it out, and then you start doing the decorations. Everything that lasts takes time. What am I trying to say? Don't say because you are 45, you are 50-something, you are 60-something, you want to quickly haste. You can't be in a haste, but I can assure you of something. If you can make up your mind that you want to sincerely follow God now, God can help you to have your result faster by supernatural means. But that's not for everybody. That's for those that don't have all the time in the world. If God can give Job more years so that he can have double what he lost, God can give you more years to enjoy the testimony that God is asking me to share with you today. Now, let me continue. I said when God wants to help you, he will send a messenger across your way. As I was about to start this episode, he said to me, even the messenger may not be a servant of God. Like the story of that young man I told you, it was one of his friends and one of his lecturers that told him, you say you want to become a doctor, but I always see you, every time you have free period, you are in the computer lab, go and study computer. It was someone God sent to him. He listened. Maybe your parents have been talking to you. Maybe your friends. Maybe your colleague. Maybe you have been having this inner thought, but you didn't respond to it. It's time to respond to it. You can never be your best until you pursue your passion. That's the truth. Now, the next thing. God help those who don't give up. Despite the enemy's attack, Gideon kept on walking. Despite the enemy's attack, Gideon kept on walking. I see many quitters in life. I see many quitters in life. I have also had that problem before. I tried so many things, and because it doesn't be result, I just drop it. But you see, I've discovered in life that people who really excel, when you are telling their story, you see that they've been there for years. I was watching a particular lady on TV having a talk show, and it's episode 15. Do you know what it means? Season 15. Do you know what that means? She's been doing it for 15 years, the same talk show. When I was in the United Kingdom as a missionary, that was the place where I first of all started learning about the secret of time, administration, and improvement. When I got to the United Kingdom, London to be precise, I would see a shop and they would say established since 1824. And I'm like, one business being this long? Wow. I would enter into such shop, I would see what they are doing. You will see the picture of the man that started it and then his son and then his grandson, you know. And I said to myself, lasting success takes time. Have you also discovered? I also discovered something in London in those days, that they improve on their system. They improve on their roads. In Nigeria, Lagos Ibadan Express Road is still a talk of the town. Repair is still talk of the town for how many years now? It doesn't happen overseas. And that's why we keep idolizing it. That's why many of us come to America. Because you think America is like heaven. But you are here now. And you see that it's not like the way you used to hear it back in Africa. Somebody was talking to me recently. He said, send me $300 now. I just smiled. I said, okay, I get you. I said, but you know they have responsibilities. My family and other people I'm trying to help. You just speak to me less than 4 days ago and you want me to send $300? I'm not sending the same check with Trump. So I'm sorry. I'll send you whatever I can send you when you give me time. What am I trying to say? People think that it's just, you know, that African mindset, that lack of administrative mindset. We even when we travel to overseas, we don't learn from their own system. Let me ask you a question. What did America have? Oil. Huh? And then what? Taxes. Do you know how many minerals we have in Africa, in Nigeria? I was in UK for Mission World for like 3-4 years. The only thing they had there is taxes. And the city is not even big. Lagos State is bigger than London.
God.
What am I trying to say? If you want to have lasting success, you have to plan. God started the process of fulfilling his prophecy with Abraham. Before Abraham died, he trained up Isaac. Isaac continued the same business. And he had the same testimony that Abraham had. He became the envy of nations. And Isaac also trained his children. He trained Jacob, he trained Esau. Jacob went to the house of Laban, do the same business. And when they went to Egypt, it was the same business. Let us start planning for generations. I know Jesus will come anytime, but we don't know the day, we don't know the hour, we don't know the month, we don't know the week. What Jesus told me in the word of God is, occupy till I come. So since I don't know when it's going to come, I should not bother my head with when it's going to come. Let me just be busy doing what he wants me to do. And if he appears before this telecast is over, fine, I am doing his will, I will go with him. But if he refuses to come for the next 100 years, I should be able to plan that my children will come to succeed. Many of us, I don't know whether I'll be able to finish this series. Many of us, you have struggled. You are working 2 jobs. Why don't you think of starting something that can make your children's life to be better? Must they go to school and finish school and start looking for work? Everybody has something that can make them great. If your child is good in a particular industry, why don't you think of how to expose them? Establish, you can establish any business in any skill, especially in this age. And in the age that we are entering into, 21st century, you can stay inside your house and sell billions of dollars of goods all over the world. Uber, where's the head office? Software. Lyft, where's the head office? Software. What am I trying to say? You can become anything. And plan for your children. Wow. It was disobedience that crippled the power of God to protect the people of Israel. God sent an angel to them and said, you know what? You guys are suffering because you refuse to follow the instruction of God. And the problem is, many of you that are watching me, you are following in the same footstep. There are things God asks you to do, you are refusing to do them, and you keep asking why things are not working for you. My question is, why will it work when you are not carrying the favor of God upon your head? Hallelujah. Why will it work? If you want God to be with you, then you've got to learn to obey God. Listen, obedience comes with sacrifice. Any obedience that you claim you are observing that does not place a price on your convenience is not obedience from God. Every time we obey God, it costs us something. But it is better to obey God than for you and your generation to suffer. God said it's because your fathers refused to follow me. They refused to obey my word. That's why they saw. That's why you guys are suffering. So don't build the citadel of suffering for your children unborn. I make up my mind that generation yet unborn will enjoy the blessings of God on my life. That's why I do whatever it costs me to obey God. You can do the same thing. You don't have to be a pastor to do it. Do you pay your tithe? Do you witness? Do you talk? Tell other people about Jesus? Do you love your wife? Do you respect your husband? Do you give to the poor? What are you doing? If you have no plan, then you have no future. That's basically the truth. Wow. Let me conclude by saying that God sees more in Gideon than what he sees in himself. Do you know why God is sending me to you right now? It's because God sees more in you than what you can see. There's a lot more in me than what I can see. And that's why I keep trusting God to open the eyes of my understanding so that I can take advantage of what God has already put in me for my generation. And that goes for you. Whether you are educated, whether you are not educated, there is an advantage that God has prepared for you. There's an opportunity that has your name tagged on it. Wow. Before I finish today, let me quickly give you success secret for today. You know, I told you, number one, put God first. Number two, identify your gifting. The last episode I told you, enroll to perfect your gifting. I said to you, there is no treasure that commands the highest price at original state. You've got to process every treasure before they can have highest value. And the fourth principle I want to share with you today is that apply for mentorship. After you have spent years learning under somebody, look for someone else that is also very good, probably better than the person who trained you, and apply for mentorship. Let me tell you the truth. Many a time, people who are very good in what they are doing, they don't have time and they don't need crowd. They don't need too many people around them. They will tell you, I don't have anything to pay you. So I will advise you, if possible, work for free. Man of God, I have my expenses. I have my bills. Which one do you prefer? To gain experience that will give you more in the future, or to work as a mediocre and earn minimum wage? It's a choice you've got to make. Secret of life, apply for mentorship. Look for someone that is very good. Someone you can work for. If they can pay you, fine. If they cannot pay you, work for free. And that tells you something. Those of you that have this mindset, I must get my right, they must pay me, you can never be great. You know why? Those who are always willing to pay you, let me tell you what they didn't tell you. They have a plan to use you until you are useless. What you want is money, Abi. They'll give you money. They might even give you a good house, a good car, but they will take your time. And time is life. They will take your opportunities because they will drain your idea. And by the time you wake up, you are too old to start anything on your own. So if you want to listen to me, apply for mentorship. If necessary, work for free. And let there be an agreement. Let there be an agreement. Don't do oral agreement. Let it be written. I'm going to work for so and so and so period. I've come to discover one thing. Experience learned can never be lost. I'm going to go right now, but before I go, I want you to help this program to continue to expand and move on. I need you to place your advert here. Number one, when you place your advert, you are helping more people to get to know about the secrets of life that can make them to manifest their glory and power. Number two, you are tapping into the anointing that God gave me for success and testimony. Listen, there's no way you will bring your product to this platform and your business will not begin to expand after a particular period of time. I'm not saying immediately, but it will begin to move and expand. I've got to go right now because time is not on my side. Call that number on the screen for advert purposes. And if you have questions, let me know. I'm Reverend Sam. I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.